Welcome to DNA Awakening Beings of Light. Our messages are provided with the intent of providing you with hope, information, and light during these times of turmoil and uncertainty. We hope you find them helpful. Never have any doubts that everything is going according to plan. When one considers all that is going on in the world at the moment, it is extremely easy to get filled with worry and uncertainty. The efforts of many people to maintain the existing quo are unrelenting, while others are exploiting the presence of rising dense energy as a pretext to carry out their own personal agendas. Individuals may only interpret the entering energy of light and empowerment in accordance with their current state of consciousness, but everyone can experience it. The third dimension is governed by the concepts of duality and separation, which show themselves in every facet of daily life. Human brains perceive and assess the world through the lens of a three-dimensional belief system that is shared by everybody. Those who are not aware of the Earth's ascension process are experiencing anxiety. Because of this, they are afraid that any change from what they are accustomed to and comfortable with would cause them to lose everything that they have fought so hard to achieve, even if their current position is unpleasant, unsatisfactory, and less than ideal. In the absence of information from the divine mind, a human mind can only understand life in terms of black and white, since it is founded on beliefs in dualism, separation, and the existence of two authorities. For people who believe in duality, separation, and the existence of two powers in awareness as fact, the pairs of opposites will always appear externally. Because awareness is always expressing itself, some people may appear to have everything working in their favor with the good of duality emerging for an extended period of time. However, sooner or later, some element of the other side of duality will manifest. Because you are consciousness and consciousness is the substance of form, you are the creators of your reality. There is no such thing as an unmanifest awareness. Because divine awareness is always expressing itself in and as infinite form and diversity, whatever is held in consciousness as truth and reality must manifest itself. You, too, are that same divine consciousness. What am I deciding to create? You should ask yourself. The presence of the strong high light frequencies presently flowing into the planet as part of the ascension process is exposing all old, outdated, and erroneous ideas that are still alive in cellular memory as well as in the Earth herself. Individuals who are in line with the growing dense energies feel empowered to act on them, which is what appears to be causing the apparent spike in crime to take place. Others who are aware of what is taking place in terms of the resurfacing of old energy are taking advantage of the current circumstances to cleanse themselves of it and move ahead with their lives. Everyone is aware of and affected by the new frequencies, which are being felt by everyone. Some people, who are spiritually asleep and uninformed of the ascension process, are finding themselves in the midst of physical, emotional, and mental struggles that they have never experienced before and are perplexed as to why this is happening. Numerous people will seek therapy, health problems will arise when they least expect them, and some people may believe they are going insane because their thinking has gotten jumbled. Blame, regrets, rage, sadness, self-loathing, and other negative emotions are coming to the surface for everyone since there is only one. Many people have made the decision to leave, and COVID has provided them with the way out they wanted. As events develop, many more people will be forced to leave because they are unable to or do not choose to connect with the higher vibrations of the ascending globe. The majority of people just see on a deeper level that they will not be able to reach the higher frequencies necessary in this lifetime and are opting to depart in order to return at a later time to a planet that is more in tune with their vibrations. Recognize that the human dying experience is always a conscious decision. For the most part, it is not a conscious decision, but it is always a decision based on free will. You should be aware that there has never been and will never be a hell, as has been taught by religions for eons of time, mostly for the purpose of enslaving their adherents. As a result, it is unaware of illusions such as pain and sorrow, or even retribution, that exist. They would be permanently fixed by divine law if they were in and of divine consciousness, and no one would be able to climb above them or modify or remove them in the future. If a person dies while in a state of awareness that is infused with ideas about hell and punishment, it is possible that they will continue to experience the manifestations of their imaginations until they are able to see through the illusion. Each and every soul has access to a constant stream of beings of light and guides who are ready to assist them the moment they ask for assistance in any form. No one has ever been or will ever be lost, since there is nothing other than divine consciousness. Never lose sight of the fact that you chose to be on Earth at this time and were fully aware of the consequences of your choice prior to incarnating in order to learn more about yourself. People's spiritual awakening, combined with the increasing presence of high-frequency light energy and the fact that they are awakening to their own spiritual selves, is causing many traditions, societal rules, and laws to crumble and dissolve into nothingness, because all that has formed and held them in place is their belief in them. The majority of the things that change or vanish will be welcomed, but a few items that you love may also be phased out. Never lose sight of the fact that nothing genuine can ever be destroyed or completely vanish, since divine law holds everything in place in perpetuity. Some things you have cherished and may have been sad to see go will reappear in new and improved forms in the future. For example, many of you are discovering that you no longer appear to have much in common with people who you used to feel quite close to in the past. Some forms of entertainment, such as television shows, novels, and other forms of media, no longer capture your attention as well as they once did, or they have come to feel dull and uninteresting. Favorite dishes that once agreed with you may no longer agree with you or appear flavorless to you. Because you are being fed more energy as you progress spiritually, you will require less material nourishment as you progress spiritually. Because you have evolved, many of the things that have been a significant part of your existence up to this point are no longer energetically in line with you, resulting in these experiences. The fact that love and friendship are spiritual truths, oneness, means that if you are looking for wholeness in your life, fresh and meaningful connections on all levels will reappear. Completeness for some may be to live alone. Because divine awareness is self-sustaining and self-maintaining, anything you want or desire in order to be joyful will unavoidably materialize in your experience after this truth has been realized and has been your achieved state consciousness. As you learn to let go of your old notions and beliefs, new hobbies, less dense food, friends, and so on will begin to appear in your life. Dear ones, trust and let the process take its course, both within and outside. Put your faith in the development of a divine purpose that cannot be halted or postponed by human thoughts or actions. A majority with God is a resounding yes. Many of you are discovering that you would like to remain quiet and away from the hustle and bustle of the outside world at this time, and that is perfectly okay. Others of you may be led to take some action of some type, and that is perfectly acceptable as long as you trust and allow your intuition to guide you through the process. Much is happening in the outside world, and it is expected to continue to happen for some time to come. You have the responsibility as a light worker to hold the light at all times and in all situations, knowing that your awareness, which has been imbued with light, is with you at all times and in all situations. Some people in your immediate vicinity will sense this light and be drawn to it, while others may sense it and be repulsed by it. Nevertheless, this is not your responsibility. Everyone's path is their own unique journey, and it is never the responsibility of another to heal, alter, mend, or save them until they express a desire to do so to others in some way. Avoid attempting to influence the thinking of another, since, contrary to popular opinion, doing so is not spiritual labor but rather the manifestation of a belief in separation, that some individuals are not one with Source and require your assistance to become enlightened. Someone you are attempting to educate may really be extremely advanced through an intentionally selected lifestyle, lesson, or experience. Everyone's free will decisions should be respected unless you are requested for direction or information, at which point you can kindly share what you know or have seen with them. Because those of you who connect with these teachings are spiritually awake and aware, your task at this time is simply to acknowledge the divinity of every person and living form that you come into contact with, engage with, read about, or think about at this moment. Most of you have already transcended the need to repair others, because you understand that everyone is already perfectly one with Source, and you no longer judge others based on their outward looks, as you once did. Change has come to the globe, my friends. It is not on its way, it has already arrived. It is likely that you will see the disintegration of many ideas held within your current systems of education and other disciplines such as science, medicine, law, religion, and so on. These are notions and views that have been recognized as great intellectual truths in the past. This will elicit protests and opposition from intellectual communities, as well as from human brains who feel that the facts and knowledge available today reflect the highest reality. From that safe and secure haven of light inside your heart, take a step back and view the world, knowing that nothing can make you anything less than who and what you already are in your divine nature. You will ultimately be fully equipped with fifth dimensional conscious awareness if you stay tuned in on a regular basis. It's possible to transcend from 3D to 5D awareness if you listen to the DNA Awakening YouTube channel and share this knowledge with others. You may also let me help you on your journey, thanks to the heavenly direction you will get when you rise into the fifth dimension. You are the light, therefore, be the light, see the light, and live the light, because you are the light. The Arcturian group is who we are. Please feel free to express your thoughts on this video in the section provided below in the comments. We appreciate all you've done for us, and we'll never forget it. We appreciate you watching, and taking the time to say hello.